resource. You showed on there, you saved the original scan with the black borders and the cropped one. You have a third one that's a color-corrected or adjusted image?
No, the library requested that we did not do any editing. We had to turn off the dust and speckle remover from Photoshop. We didn't do any color correction. And for some of them, I think that would be difficult anyway because the colors are so faded. I'm not even sure that we could even get a real color. But I think it would be well to have something like that, to have a third image.
And another question, so did you have many instances of like reciprocal illumination where, let's say, you have a slide, but the metadata is really poor, but you found the specimen in the collection, and that had metadata that could then inform your slide? Or you have a specimen in the collection that the metadata is really poor, but you got a slide of it, and the slide's got a date or something like that. Did you have many instances of that?
We had a few, but I think the metadata on the slides was generally the lesser information. So we had pretty good information from the field books for the voucher specimens, but less on the slides.
Yep. People who stand and receive the material, is there any part of your project that involves dust, mold, and any kind of part of cleaning of the images before you start?
Yes, we air dusted the images before they were scanned. And that removed most of the dust and speckles that we couldn't remove with Photoshop.
Yeah, I thought you asked before, you didn't do any post processing or scratches of dust.
The library requested that we did not touch the slides, which is probably wise. Yep. No, we were required to not compress files.
Why was that? Just
that was provided in the guidelines that the library gave us. So we were kind of constrained by what they expected from us, unfortunately. So we had to give them what they asked for.
So I mean, the comment, there's a couple of comment and questions. So there's a couple of questions about why they were requiring you to not fool around with the images too much.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of that is because with guidelines of digitization of images or anything, like if you're taking a photograph of your objects or your specimens, and again, like Gil said, libraries are like way ahead of us. And so it's because how much editing is too much? How much are you distorting that original image? Like if you play around with the color, how much does that just change the original color of your specimen? And somebody goes, oh my God, you've got a blue gill with green eyes? What the heck's going on there? You know, and that's not what it is, you know. So they do require that you don't do any compression, you don't do any of that, so that the image itself is in its raw state, that it's been untouched. I mean, there's a certain amount of editing that you can do, but you never brush stroke anything out. Scratches, dents, whatever you got, leave it all in there so that it's as is original information. So that's part of that. Now my question to you is, did you have a database before this? Or do you have a separate database? Because I know they said that they're using FileWave Pro, but do you have your own database?
Yes, we have a modified access database. So we have it, but it doesn't currently have any way to link to the FileWave Pro database.
So that was thinking, wow, how do you manage the two different databases? So would you load your information as you were going into your own database and then as well supply it to the library?
No. I don't think ours could handle it size-wise. So all of the information, that's why the metadata was such a nightmare to try to make sure that everything was connected after all of the images were taken in the FileMaker Pro database. Like I said, it's up on web, it looks really great, but behind the scenes, it's not great at all. So
I'm going to move to the next speaker. I also want to say that Laura gets all